वेलकम ऑल। सो टिल नाउ वी वर रिप्रेजेंटिंग वोल्टेज एज द पीक एम्पलीट्यूड वोल्टेज एंड करंट एज द पीक एम्पलीट्यूड करंट। नाउ नेक्स्ट इज वी विल रिप्रेजेंट वोल्टेज एंड करंट एज विद देयर आरएमएस वैल्यू। जनरली अवर वोल्टमीटर एंड एमीटर ऑल्सो मेजर द आरएमएस वैल्यू ऑफ वोल्टेज एंड करंट। सो डेफिनेशन इज इट इज द इफेक्टिव वैल्यू ऑफ टाइम वेरिंग वोल्टेज एंड करंट। Why we are defining this RMS value? Because it would deliver the same average power as that would be delivered by an AC source. So suppose if I have one AC source and one if I have one DC source. So as RMS value is the effective value or DC value, so this will deliver the same average power as that would be delivered by an AC source. So this RMS value will deliver the same average power as that would be delivered by an AC source. The formula is for voltage VRMS equal to under root of 1 by T integration 0 to T V square of T dt. It is very simple. First of all, root. So take one root here. Then mean value. So 1 by T integration 0 to T V of T dt. Then square. So square that voltage. Similarly for current, high RMS value. Under root, so first of all we will take one root, then mean value 1 by t integration 0 to t I of t dt, then square of that current. So this is how VRMS and IRMS are defined. And if you have a sinusoidal signal, there is one relationship between RMS value and peak value. So VRMS equal to Vm by root 2 and IRMS equal to Im by root 2. We know that average power formula 1 by 2 Vm Im cos of theta V minus theta I. So this 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2, that means Vm by root 2. This 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2. So Vm by root 2 is nothing but VRMS, Im by root 2 is nothing but IRMS. So average power formula becomes VRMS, IRMS, cos of theta V minus theta I, because Vm by root 2 is nothing but VRMS, Im by root 2 is nothing but IRMS. So this is how average power can be defined. Your voltmeter ammeter measures the RMS value of voltage and current, and in your household you might have a 230 volt. So that 230 volt is nothing but the RMS value, not the peak value of voltage. Okay, let's look at this example. Determine RMS value of waveform shown in figure. So one waveform is shown and we have to determine the RMS value of that waveform. Also we have to find out how much power is delivered to 2 ohm resistor. That means R value is 2 ohm and we have to determine the power delivered to this resistor. Okay, so to solve such type of numerical, first thing is you should identify the time period of the signal. So as you can see, we are having one positive cycle, then negative cycle, again we have one positive cycle. So at zero we are having positive cycle, again we are getting positive cycle at 4. So after 4 seconds we are having repetition. So the period of the signal is 4 seconds. Once you have find out the period, now next is you should find out the equation of V of t. You should determine the equation of V of t. So between 0 to t, between 0 to 2, in this time interval 0 to 2, how your V of t is defined? V of t equal to 2. And from 2 to 4, V of t equal to minus 3. From 2 to 4, V of t equal to minus 3. So I have written the time period, I have written the V of t from 0 to 2, V of t equal to 2, and from 2 to 4, V of t equal to 3, minus 3 from graph, from the waveform. Then just write down the formula of VRMS, under root 1 by t integration 0 to t V square of t dt. But between 0 to t, it is not constant, it is changing. Between from 0 to 2, it is 2, and from 2 to 4, it is minus 3. So I need to split the integration. So this 0 to 4 integration I will split into 0 to 2 and 2 to 4. Then from 0 to 2, what is the value? 2. So 2 square 4. And from 2 to 4, what is the value? Minus 3. Minus 3 square means 9. And if you just solve this, VRMS value comes out as under root 26 by 2 volt. Then also we have to determine the average power. So VRMS square divided by R is the formula. Vrms value is under root 26 by 2 and resistance given in the question is 2. So solve this, you will get the answer as 3.25 watt. Okay. So next, a variable x is shown in figure as a function of time. The root mean square value of x is. So this is a GATE examination question in the year 2014. Okay. So first step is you should find out the time period. So as you can see, T by 2 is given. That means overall period is capital T. No values are written here. That means overall period is nothing but capital T. Then second thing, you should define your x of t. So from 0 to t by 2, this is t by 2. From 0 to t by 2, it is a one straight line passing through origin. So I need to write down its equation. And from t by 2 to capital T, the x of t is 0. X of t is nothing but 0. But I need to write down the equation from 0 to t by 2. Okay, so this is a straight line passing through origin. The equation is y equal to mx, where m is the slope, and on y axis, as I have x of t, so x of t equal to m into x axis is small t, so t here. Then you can pause the video and you can find out the slope. Okay, so I hope you have got the value of slope. Then x coordinates are 0 comma t by 2, y coordinates are 0 comma 1, y coordinates are 0 comma 1, x coordinates are 0 comma t by 2. So slope is nothing but y2 minus y1. So this is y2, this is y1. So 1 minus 0 divided by x2 minus x1, so t by 2 minus 0. So this is the formula of slope, y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So if the slope comes out as 2 by t, so y x of t equal to 2 by t into small t. So this is the equation from 0 to t by 2, and from t by 2 to t, its value is 0. Then write down the formula of xrms, under root 1 by t integration 0 to t x square of t dt. And split the integration 0 to t by 2, and from t by 2 to t, its value is 0, so that integration will be 0. Okay, then just put the value of x of t from in the interval 0 to t by 2, so it is nothing but 2 by t into small t. Then this 2 by t is a constant because we are integrating with respect to t. So take the square and take it outside the integration. So 2 square is 4, t square is t square, and already t is there, so it becomes t cube. And then t square integration is t cube by 3. So put the upper limit minus lower limit, t cube cancel. Answer comes out as under root 1 by 6. So RMS value is 0.408. Now let's look at one more GATE examination question, GATE 2004. The RMS value of the periodic waveform given in the figure is. Okay. So what is the time period of the signal? So you can see here at origin, we are getting negative cycle. Again, here from here, we are getting the negative cycle. So the overall time period is 0 to T. That means time period is T because after that we have a repetition. The next step is you should write down the equation of I of T between this interval. So from t by 2 to t, what is the value? 6. Simple, it is a constant 6. But from 0 to t by 2, again it is a straight line passing through origin. So I of t equal to slope into small t. M is the slope into small t. You can pause the video and find out the slope. Okay. So x coordinates are 0 comma t by 2. Y coordinates are 0 comma minus 6. The slope is y2 minus y1. So minus 6 minus 0 divided by x2 minus x1. So t by 2 minus 0. So it comes out as minus 12 by t. I hope you got the answer of slope as minus 12 by t also. Then I of t equal to minus 12 by t into small t between 0 to t by 2, and it is 6 from t by 2 to capital T. Then afterwards you just have to solve the integration. So first split the integration, because it is defined in two interval. Your I of t is defined in two interval. So 0 to t by 2 is one interval, and t by 2 to t is another interval. Then from 0 to t by 2, it is 12 by t into t minus 12 by t into t, because of square. It becomes 144 t square small t square. And from t by 2 to 2, it is a 6. So 6 square, 36. Then as we are integrating with respect to small t, this term is a constant. Take outside the integration. And t square integration is t cube by 3. Then put upper limit minus lower limit. Upper limit minus lower limit. Dt integration is t. Upper limit minus lower limit. And if you solve this, you will get the answer as 2 root 6. Okay. Thank you.